In this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can send photos as documents in WhatsApp on the iPhone. And the reason for it and the reason why you clicked on the video is because you would like to send photos to someone but would not like to get the quality compressed. You would like to send the actual image with all the size and all the quality that it currently has. And I get you, it's definitely a great idea to preserve the quality. But there are some things to consider. Since you have an iPhone, you could use iMessage, because as you probably know, iMessage doesn't compress images a lot. So the quality is great and the photo looks sharp and decent with all the colors if you send using iMessage, but that implies that you have it set up and you're sending it to someone that also has iMessage and of course iPhone. So this may not always work, and also people advise against using iMessage for sending photos because you also share all of the location things in case you don't turn it off manually for all of the photos, which kind of sucks because it's you're sharing your privacy and all of the hidden information about it, like where the photo has been taken and stuff, and you don't have that on WhatsApp. So in regards to quality, iMessage is great, but if you intend on using WhatsApp, here is how you can do it. So you open up the Photos app on the iPhone. That is that you already have the photo that you would like to share. So you click on the share icon or more options icon in the lower left corner, and it's going to show you multiple things. Like, of course, if you click on WhatsApp and share it to directly to your WhatsApp contacts, it's just going to compress it and not much, but it's definitely going to make the quality worse. But if you scroll down a bit, you're going to find the option to save the photo to files. So you can see it somewhere around here. So you can see that you can even copy it to documents, but save to files, to iOS files, is the way to go. So you click on it and you choose the location, of course. So you can save it wherever you want, but it's up to you, of course. Make sure to hit done and the photo is going to be saved there. By the way, guys, if you are new on this channel, if this is your first visit on this Apple Fox channel, you should consider subscribing because this is definitely not my first WhatsApp video. I also talk about iPad WhatsApp on the Apple Watch and stuff, and also other Apple-related content. So I think that you would benefit from subscribing. You will stay up to date and it also helps the channel. So it's up to you. You can do it. And also leave a thumbs up if you like the video so far. Okay, let's continue. Okay, the process is that now you open up WhatsApp and you go to any chat or content, and you now want to share the file that you saved to your Files app. So you click on plus and you click on document because this is the option to go, and it's gonna open up the Files app, and the recent is probably the one that you just saved, the folder that you just saved to Files. So just click on it, and now it means that you send it as a document. It's not going to be a regular photo. It's just going to be a document of that. So this is exactly what we wanted to achieve. So right now, even in the chat bubbles, you can see that the photo preview is not there. It's not a regular photo, but just you can see like an icon of it with the title and with the name. It's actually a document. And this means that the photo has the complete quality, it's completely preserved, and it's it's exactly what we wanted to get. And now let me show you how you can actually view or what you can do with the photo. Since it is just a document, it's not the regular photo, as you would say. If you click on it, it shows up. I mean, of course you can load it, but you now have to save it to your gallery. So you're gonna click and see the share icon at the top, which is pretty much the only option, and scroll down and you have to save the image or use any other method of, let's say, sharing or saving the photo on your device. So it's kind of more complicated. There are a couple of steps in between, but keep in mind that we are doing this to preserve the maximum quality of this and still using WhatsApp, which, like I say, isn't the worst thing, even if you send through WhatsApp without any documents stuff, just like we do right now, but it's still better to keep the maximum quality. So what are the other options that we have? If you think about it, most people use Messenger from Facebook, which is okay and fast, but the compressing is just insane. The photos visually look terrible after sending them. So, I mean, it's great for stuff that you don't really care about the quality that much, or like a thing that you only need to see once. But for some more serious photos, definitely don't use that. iMessage is a great option. Just keep in mind that you have to care about your privacy and the location of the photos. Then you have a WhatsApp, which is great. And even if you don't use this method, the quality is still going to be better than in Facebook Messenger. But using the files stuff, I think that you should preserve the maximum quality. Besides that, we have Instagram DMs, which is, I would say, better than Messenger from Facebook, even though Instagram is from Facebook as well. But a lot more people use Instagram to preserve more quality compared to Messenger. But yeah, WhatsApp definitely tops both of them. And other options will probably not be that good. If you take a look at Signal, a lot of people use that, but that also compresses the images. If you really want to keep the full quality, just use this method or upload them to a cloud or use a physical hard drive or USB to send it to someone or give it to them or whatever. But just don't use these Messenger platforms because they will definitely compress it. Okay, that would be pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed this video and found some value in it. In case you liked it, follow for more, and I mean subscribe, of course, and leave a thumbs up if this helped you or you found it helpful. So thanks a lot for watching. See you guys later in the next one.